press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss a video from News Laundry.
Rolling.
East to yo, FOE.
Move it.
Please put the camera on my cynical face. I don't believe one word of this.
Answer that.
Position.
Position,
I mean.
Bharat Mata ki.
Yeah.
So yo.
अंग्रेज अपना लगान और न्यूज़ लॉन्ड्री अपना हफ्ता कभी नहीं छोड़ते. वेलकम टू न्यूज़ लॉन्ड्री हफ्ता. आई एम अभिनंदन सेखरी एंड मी आई हैव अ स्पार्कलिंग पैनल टुडे. बट बिफोर आई कम टू द पैनल मे आई प्लग वंस अगेन, सब्सक्राइब टू न्यूज़ लॉन्ड्री, पे टू कीप न्यूज़ फ्री, बिकॉज व्हेन द पब्लिक पेज द पब्लिक इज सर्व्ड, व्हेन एडवर्टाइजर्स पे एडवर्टाइजर्स सर्व्ड. ऑल्सो टू इंपॉर्टेंट अनाउंसमेंट्स ऑन द हफ्ता टुडे. वी हैव एन इवेंट ऑन द 2nd ऑफ अक्टूबर. आई विल टेल यू लिटिल मोर अबाउट दैट. इट्स ओपन फॉर सब्सक्राइबर्स ओनली. सो मुफ्त खोर्स, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू अटेंड दैट इवेंट एंड आई सजेस्ट यू डू, there'll be a really good conversation, and of course you can meet us as well. You'll have to subscribe. And there is another announcement about yes, there's a chat box on Saturday for our NRI audience, but more on that as the hafta goes. First let me introduce the panel. I have with me Rishi Majumder. Hi Rishi.
Hi.
Rishi has been a writer, journalist, and media consultant for over 13 years. Really, that long? He was
14 or 15 now. You're probably reading from an older bio.
Oh my god, older bio. So that I'll blame Parikshit for that. But no, I guess it's recent enough. You've been with the Times of India, Mumbai Mirror. You were the ex-editor of Vice. You were a principal correspondent of Tehelka and a senior editor of The Big Indian Picture. What is that?
That's a film website that we ran for 3 years. It was a website on cinema and culture, videos as well as text.
So you're a cinema aficionado,
aficionado.
Aficionado. So have you seen Manto?
I haven't seen Manto yet. I'm waiting to see.
Has anyone seen Manto here?
Should one see it? Have you seen it?
I've heard great things about it.
I thought I'd get to know if I'm being too harsh, but no one's seen
it.
It's
not good.
I thought it was.
He's become one because of Awful and Awesome. No?
I have to watch a film every week now. Otherwise, I have nothing to talk about an Awful and Awesome. So he writes articles, features, essays, commentary for NDTV, The Dawn, The Hindu, Hindustan Times, Yahoo Originals, First Post, India Today. My God, you've written for pretty much everyone. So that's Rishi.
Were you changing jobs every week?
No, I was just freelancing. I was freelancing for a long time.
Okay. Freelance, he's a long time freelancer. And then we have award winning Manisha.
Hi.
Who has
award winning
Manisha.
Yeah,
award is now. Now we should really stop.
We should really stop now. Okay, we'll stop.
It's an old award.
We have Meghnad, the latest digital celebrity in the house, yo. Who does, he's the, what DJs are to music, he's to the Constitution, section 25, move it,
oh section my 86. God,
okay, and then, like, what,
worst
what,
introduction ever, like.
What Pearl Jam is to rock concerts, he's to, yo, FOE, section 19A, like that, so he does a lot of these.
Did you mean section 66, eh?
No, 19, na?
Actually,
amendment.
19.
Art amendment.
Article.
You said 9. Actually, 9A. I was wondering what I'd
missed. तभी तो मैं यहाँ बैठा हूँ और ये वहाँ जाके perform करता है. नहीं तो मैं नहीं कर रहा था. बाल भी एक ही हैं. Experience भी है. मैं बुढ़ा भी हूँ.
Noxial.
खैर. So yes, he is here because today, other than the fact that we love him very much, he's also here because today there's been a landmark judgment of Aadhaar, which has hit him like a kick in the nuts.
Yeah, absolutely. He's right.
Something like that. So
1400 pages worth of nuts.
Just
it's 1400 pages.
1400 pages.
Wow. And we have our editor-in-chief, Madhu Trehan, a non-Padma Shri winning journalist.
And we'll never, ever, ever see the light of Padma Shri.
I haven't given you this grand intro for a long time. The founding editor of India Today, the magazine set up by her, founder of TV Today, which is today Aaj Tak and India Today and Headlines Today, founder of News Laundry, founder of something called Why India, which was ahead
flopped,
of its time.
Which flopped. Which was ahead of its time.
It was ahead of its time.
Yeah, you don't say flop. You just say, no one got it.
But
too avant-garde.
It was a digital product before digital was in India, when there were just like 0.1% people had access to digital. So, on that note, we have a bunch of stuff we're going to talk about. I'll just tell you some of the things. I'll tell you the headlines. We may not discuss all of them. Indian government suggested Reliance as partner in a Rafale deal. How do you pronounce it? First of all, just can you get
Rafale.
An answer?
Rafale.
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 Rafale. Rafale. Rafale.
Rafale.
Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale. Rafale Jetli, Sekhri.
This is a funny video, actually, everyone pronouncing it.
So, Indian government suggested Reliance has partnered in Rafale deal. Hollandi tells French website. Hollandi and Rafale.
Hollandi. Hollandi ne sara gadbad kar di. Macron.
Macron is also something to eat, na?
That's macaroons.
So, wahi to macaroon. Then, Bangladeshi migrants are termites will be removed from voters' lists, says Amit Shah in his charming way. I don't know if... Does anyone know if Amit Shah had a love marriage or arranged marriage? I don't know. How would he have charmed the woman in his life?
You never know how he was when in his younger days, no?
I think from reports, it was arranged.
It was arranged. Because I'd love to see how he charms someone. Like his charm offensive would be quite something.
He has charmed the only person that matters. He's charmed the only person that matters. Adarniya Modi ji.
Modi ji. He's very charming. Indo-Pak talks, BJP lashed out at Pakistan PM Imran Khan. Imran Khan tweets something rather undiplomatic. I think he is going the Trump way when it comes to conducting foreign relations. Supreme Court referral of FGM case, that is the female genital mutilation, to the constitutional bench and attempt to reframe the issue. I think it's quite shocking that such an issue has to go to a 5-judge bench.
Yeah, constitutional bench. It doesn't make sense.
Then the Aadhaar case. Today, there were lots of important cases. There was the Aadhaar case today. What else?
Live streaming of court proceedings.
Reservation in private sector?
Reservation.
That is still to happen yet?
No, reservation with regard to promotion.
Promotion.
Private sector.
And the Ram Mandir case is also due sometime soon. Then the Rahul Gandhi's gali gali mein shor hai, Hindustan ka chaukidar chor hai has caught on, and of course it has really angered everyone, but it has angered the most, it has angered our law minister, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, who has made statements that such language has never been used for a Prime Minister of India before.
During Bofors, it was constant.
And Manmohan Singh also was called chor.
Mera PM chor hai.
It was very common during Rajiv Gandhi's prime ministership.
But the thing about Ravi Shankar Prasad, I've noticed, like Trump is, like Trump, everything that happened, the biggest in the world. Like he invented like everything.
Yeah, everything.
Ravi Shankar Prasad is like that. He's so outraged that this has never happened before. Yeah. Everything he says has never happened before.
Like Shobha Day, when she discovered feminism, she behaved like she invented it.
Yeah.
A bit late in the day also.
Shobhade, when she discovered Raghuram Rajan also.
I know, that was really sexy chairman of the reserve.
Sex in the Sensex, apparently.
How do you see a reserve bank guy as sexy? It's not possible.
I don't know. Depends on your position. I mean, how are your positions this time? I mean, in scrapes, in mid caps, low caps, depending on how you positioned.
No way.
Well, can I bring up Donald Trump's tweet? So Donald Trump tweeted, "The Democrats are working hard to destroy a wonderful man, a man who has the potential to be one of our greatest Supreme Court justices ever, with an array of false accusations, the likes of which have never been seen before." Ever. He meant accusations. The president of America does not know how to spell accusations, so he writes acquisitions, and then Trevor Noah retweets it with "What a maroon."
But I will say, in defense of bad spellers, being one myself, I think good spelling is an overrated virtue. Just saying.
And the height of arrogance is that whatever you're bad at, it's an overrated virtue.
Yeah.
Height of arrogance. Wait, or just turn it into this vaccine.
What do you want to
do? So let's start with Aadhaar. First of all, let me start with our guest, although I know you're also a guest, but you're a ghar ka guest.
Yeah.
Ghar ka guest.
But you're a boy. He's here every day.
Not every day.
Every week. So your take on the Aadhaar, are you disappointed with the judgment? But were you expecting anything different?
Well, I mean, one didn't expect one thing or the other. It's an absolutely ridiculous judgment. I mean, in a lot of ways. For one thing, this whole idea of play of words that, we cannot be number one, but at least we are unique. Okay, just to put it down, it's a bit ridiculous because, there are ways in which people or bodies of people can be unique that can be really disturbing. I mean, the unique identification authority has very uniquely distributed identities to people, unique people who don't exist. Right. So this is like Yeah, exactly. For one thing. Otherwise, besides that, I mean, you know, just, I mean, one thing, privacy being infringed without a context. We don't know what the data protection laws are. We don't know what the data protection framework is going to be. It's putting the cart before the horse. It's, you know, without giving me a context of how you're going to protect my privacy, you decide to sit in judgment on it. Cost-benefit analysis, you know, in terms of beneficiaries not receiving benefits. You know, one of the big things about Aadhaar is it's supposed to be a miracle. And a lot of people are supposed to be getting a lot of benefits. What are the studies that have been done on this? You look at the studies that have been done, you find social audits in North India, and you find a lot of beneficiaries who've actually been struck off the beneficiary lists. And now the government is touting this as a big success by saying, see, we've saved so much money. Firstly, as a government, what's your objective? Is your objective to save money? Is it to make sure that benefits reach the beneficiaries? And there are so many accounts of beneficiaries who deserve pensions, who deserve their right to food, who deserve Manrega, and who are now being struck off the beneficiary list because of complete mismanagement, or are suffering because of other problems that technology has brought about instead of solving. You know, and finally, this case of constitutional fraud, which I'm sure that Meghnad will talk about a lot more, but which Justice Chandrachur has spoken about.
So clearly, you're dissatisfied with the...
Hugely,
so,
yeah.
Briefly, Meghnad, could you just tell me what are the key takeaways? One is that you need an Aadhaar if you're filing tax returns, so I'll have to get an Aadhaar made. Yeah. So, my fight, I have met haar gaya, Meghnad, wo jeet
gaya. I also...
Wo jeet gaya, Meghnad.
Main bhi haar gaya. Main bhi haar gaya, bhai.
Main bhi haar gaya. Hum dono haar gaya. Hamari daadi hame nahi bacha pai. So what all up key things batao, but before you come to the key things, I will say that you mentioned Hanuman has an Aadhaar card, which he should. And I'll tell you why. Because there are seven immortals. All you pseudo seculars don't know the basics of your own religion.
I'm sorry. He also has an LPG connection.
There is Ashwathama Balir Vyaso Hanumanash Cha Vibhishana Kripacharya Cha Parshuram Saptah Chiranjeevam. These seven people are immortal. Hanuman.
So that I didn't know.
You didn't know?
I thought only Ashwathama
King Mahabali, Vedvyas, Hanuman, Vibhishan, Kripacharya, and Parshuram can never die. So they still are hanging around somewhere. In fact, there is a theory that the Yeti is
cave
Hanuman.
Cave theory? Yes, I have heard
that
this.
The Bigfoot is Hanuman.
I have seen the photo also.
So they have to have. So if this myth is
I
true.
I haven't heard this theory. This is quite amazing. I mean, I've heard of the Chiranjeevi theory. I haven't heard of Yeti being Hanuman. This is quite amazing. Thank you.
So, in fact, there is an Ashwathama temple in UP where apparently Ashwathama comes every day, and myth has it, in fact, I want to shoot it at some point, but they don't let you spend the night, that he comes every day and you can identify him because he took out that money, now he had that money on his forehead. So, anyway, my point being that these seven people also have to Aadhaar card. So, now, this government is in a position of deciding once and for all, is this myth or history? Because if these seven people don't come up with an Aadhaar card, then this is not true.
Oh God.
Bang.
Such a long story for
Are you
this.
Going to drop the mic or something?
Yeah.
You've already purified the podcast with your power knowledge. But so first I will just, for the benefit of the listeners, I will just read out the quote that you were mentioning, right? So the judgment apparently now starts with a quote all the time. So the quote reads, "It is better to be unique than the best. Because being the best makes you the number one, but being unique makes you the only one."
Well, nice. Who is this? Justice?
That's Sikri. Justice Sikri.
Irshad. Kya baat hai?
No, wait a minute. He didn't make that up.
No, he probably Googled it, of but course. Still. I mean, like.
See, Madhu.
Probably some Archie's card.
As Anumalik said. As in God. कोई यूनिक नहीं नौशाद सब चीटिंग करते थे बप्पी दा कॉपी करते सब कॉपी करते हैं नो वन इज यूनिक तो नो वन यूनिक सब गूगल करके करते ना
प्लीज पुट द कैमरा ऑन माय सिनिकल फेस आई डोंट बिलीव वन वर्ड ऑफ दिस
So the key takeaways of basically the judgment is that everybody has to get Aadhaar now. It is mandatory for people who want to file income tax. It is mandatory for people who want to get subsidies, basically.
So for subsidies and, it is, for PDS, for rice, PDS, for whatever.
Government subsidies.
Explain to me, because I saw one flash which said no one can be denied an entitlement.
So the Supreme Court has also observed that we are not trivializing the whole exclusion part of it, but we can't throw the baby out of the bathwater, Like what? Bath water out of the water. Yeah, jo bhi saying hai.
So what they're saying is, while they said you cannot deny someone entitlements because you don't have adhar, but yet you have to have another adhar.
You have to have another adhar because Section for 7, the right? sake of a few, we can't, you know, afford to not let the others get the benefit. That is their argument. And what they've also said that the government has to ensure that if there is no working adhar in a particular place, they have to make provisions for alternate IDs so that they get subsidies. That was already happening. Like, state governments had already given directives on that.
What is your biggest beef with this?
So the biggest beef with this is that, you know, the money bill part. Right, so Aadhaar, and I remember I started writing for News Laundry because of that, actually.
Right.
So Aadhaar, when it was passed as a money bill, meaning that it could completely bypass Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha mein BJP has majority, so their only objective was ki Rajya Sabha should not stall it. So they got it like on a Friday, which was a last moment thing. They brought it in, many members were not present, and they just bulldozed it through, did not let Rajya Sabha give any opinion, and then they basically passed the bill. Now they passed it as a money bill, which is a problem because money bills are specifically bills which concern spendings from the Consolidated Fund of India. Now this, which they had titled Aadhaar Subsidy Delivery Bill, they argued that because it's about subsidy delivery, it has to be a money bill, right? But it's not. It is a mechanism through which the subsidy is delivered.
And
it's not
a money bill
itself.
Need not be debated. It can just go through.
It has to be debated in Lok Sabha. I mean, any bill has to be debated, sure, technically. Hmm. But Rajya Sabha, it can bypass. It can only give recommendations.
So that
Lok Sabha, they have a...
Yeah.
So they've used a technicality to bypass the Rajya Sabha where they don't have majority.
So that was one of my biggest things, that, you know, at least ispe to kuch Supreme Court bolega.
But on this, Supreme Court said it's okay.
It's okay.
So then it sets a precedent that if anybody wants to do anything by bypassing the Rajya Sabha, money bill.
Absolutely.
You simply label it a money bill and then get
and
it passed.
And they did it already, right? Like finance bill, which
finance
they passed.
Bill enters a money
they
bill.
Passed it as a money bill. They had like provisions from the RBI Act and more acts which were not supposed to be there. Like money bill pass karte ja rahe.
So are you going to be writing a piece explaining this?
I will
so do read Meghnad's detailed piece on this judgment.
Why not a video?
He's already put out a video yesterday.
Yeah.
So that video just went out yesterday. We'll have a piece. Madhu, you want to add anything on this Aadhaar tippani? Manisha?
No, not really. Except I think Justice Chandrachur's dissenting opinion is of importance, though, I mean, he gets overruled, but apparently you can cite that in future judgments.
Yeah.
So him making his dissent clear.
Very
is
clear.
Sort
he
of,
scrapped the whole project.
And he said that it's a constitutional violation. It goes in, also on the money bill, he said. So this
it,
is important because...
It violates right to privacy. It violates the constitutional provisions for money bills. Everything. So he's...
So, okay, so before
also
move
one more interesting.
Meghnad, do you think this judgment was partisan?
I wouldn't say that because Aadhaar is not partisan, technically.
Technically,
because,
but it was started by the UPA. These guys carried it on further.
Made it worse.
And there are certain areas which both, whichever government is in power, they're always doing the same thing. The way they treat the press, the way they...
RTI,
they
want to kill the RTI.
Farmers, the way they kill the RTI.
Transparency and political funding.
Exactly, so there's all similarities to both governments. So in this, it was the issue was non-partisan in any case. It was really the people against the state.
Absolutely. And plus, I think there is a giant bureaucratic push behind this, right? Because I don't know how this happened, but somehow our bureaucrats are convinced, and I've been in meetings where I have heard this, that every solution, every problem ka solution is Aadhaar. Like, for instance, I went to this meeting, I won't name where or whatever. It was a labor meeting where they were trying to figure out how to
Noxial
basically prevent it was a proper
sarkari meeting.
Sarkari thing. So they were trying to figure out how to basically prevent migrant laborers from getting abused. So like literally three bureaucrats got up and said, Aadhaar card laga do. Get them Aadhaar card, so they'll be tracked. And
this is like Manmohan Singh. Now, when I remember that time also, I wrote in a piece that when the only tool you have is a hammer, every problem looks like a nail. All he had was economics. So for him, every solution was an economic solution, even if it had to do with justice and courts and basic, you know, human values. No, economics. Privatize it and it'll get fixed. It's, I mean, it's a very typical But
just one thing, what about surveillance? Did they say anything about surveillance on Aadhaar?
So they said clearly that Aadhaar is not enabling surveillance because it collects minimal information, according to the Supreme Court. And there are enough safeguards in place. And then they have given like a whole brief on how data protection is going to protect us all. And they've given a whole brief of the draft bill that is coming up. And Shri Krishna Committee ke report se copy-paste kar diya pura sab kuch.
So,
can I add just one small quick thing? You know, the money bill thing, one thing was Section 56, where they spoke about in the Aadhaar, in the bill itself, where they spoke about private parties being facilitated.
That is one more important thing. Yeah.
So that section was read down. Hmm. But the problem is people are looking at it like, oh, okay, so this section would have was because it. When you're dealing with private parties, you're telling what banks are telling banks what they are allowed to do. You're telling phone companies what they're allowed to do. So how can it be a money bill, right?
Yeah.
So people are looking at it like, okay, they've read this section down. Now it's okay. It's not okay. The problem is this section was there in this bill when it was passed through parliament in this manner.
Mm.
It's like I fraudulently get into a contract with Abhinandan.
Mm.
And then when I get into that contract with him, all right, later on when Abhinandan goes to court and says, look, he used fraud to get into this contract with me. And then the court says, I'm just going to strike out those provisions of the contract, all right, which Abhinandan would have had a problem with. Abhinandan says, no, hang on. It was fraud. I have a problem with this contract.
Yeah.
Just go back. Scrap it all. Let's start from the beginning. So that's a problematic procedure.
That's very actually good way of...
And you know, the summary of this judgment would be, and the reason why there are people I've been watching news coverage also, they're calling it a balanced judgment. You know, where private parties.
I think
parties
the problem is
the
government is trying to do too much of balancing in all their judgments.
But
that's
here, I think the main problem is all these, you know, basically elite who were getting like irritated. Are kitne messages aa rahe hai, bank ko link karo ye wo, like mummy dekho message aa raha hai, phone ko link karne ke liye, etc. Those have been placated. Now the poor, they still have to get Aadhaar. Unko koi relief
exactly.
nahi hai.
100%. Well, actually, that's a huge problem.
Even we have to file IT returns.
We have to file. So everybody has to. But
like
for
the basic needs, you know, for food and all of that, they're still stuck.
So do watch out for, you know, Meghnad's piece on this. We are going to discontinue the video now. The rest of the podcast is available in audio. But we just want to put out this video because it is International Podcast Day. So on International Podcast Day, we thought we'd also give you an idea of how we record this podcast. So yo, say yo, you all.
Yo.
Yo. Madhu, say yo.
Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
No, you have to say Bharat Mata.
Ki jai.
Bharat Mata ki
jai. Okay. So I have an important announcement to make, people. This Gandhi Jayanti on our dearest Bapu's birthday, News Laundry Hindi and all of us are hosting a discussion at the India Islamic Center in near Lodhi Estate, or it's on Lodhi Road. It's at 6 p.m. in the evening. It's open for subscribers only. If you become a subscriber, you can also come. There will be a conversation hosted by the moderator is Nagma Seher from NDTV. It's a conversation between Kumar Prashant, who heads the Gandhi Peace Foundation, and Ajay Upadhyay, who's a leader of the Swadeshi Jagran Manch. And the subject we'll be discussing is Bapu's nationalism as opposed to the RSS nationalism, how similar and dissimilar is it? It is a Hindi conversation. I'm sure there's lots we'll all learn. So I suggest you be there and come and say hi. And we'll also give you tea and biscuits, I think, if budget allows. So yeah, come.